Black women, we are failing our black men. We're failing them in a sense of that we are overprotecting them to the point where it's costing us our daughters, our sisters, ourselves, and even more importantly, probably, is our sanity. So I understand why we do this. This actually stems back from slavery, having to protect them against the white man or our enemies. However, sometimes, especially as of late, sorry guys, I'm at work, so thought somebody was coming in. Especially as of late, we seem to be doing that when it comes to people like R. Kelly and Bill Cosby. I keep seeing memes and posts about the media's out to attack our black men. Yes, they do that. But sometimes these black men need to be attacked. And sadly, because we as black women stand by them through thick and thin, right and wrong, it's oftentimes the media who has to call them out on their stuff. R. Kelly is not a secret. Bill Cosby was not a secret. Okay, but let's go even further. Let's talk about the dude you messing with. Let's talk about your next door neighbor. Let's talk about your cousin and them who is doing some effed up stuff in these streets. And when they get caught, we automatically as women be like, well, why he do it? Or no, I'm sorry, not even why he did it, because you know he did it. We say, well, he had a difficult childhood. Oh, well, he been doing it. Guess what, sis? And he should have been got caught. You probably should have called him out on his stuff, and maybe that would have stopped him. But that's not what we did. We baby them. We make them feel like they don't have to be responsible for their actions. We can make them feel like they can keep ignoring what they're doing. We make them feel like it's okay because we right here standing in your corner. Listen, if you full of fuckery, why the heck will I support your fuckery? I can't do it. I've done it, and I paid the cost. Trust when I say I paid the cost. That's why I won't do it again. In 2019, ladies, love that black man who ain't a piece. A piece of a black man is someone who goes after kids. A piece of a black man is someone who rapes. A piece of a man, a black man, is one who doesn't take care of responsibilities. A piece of a black man is the one who brought you down. Stop protecting that piece of a black man. Continue to protect your black kings. Listen, a black king deserves our protection. The ones who bust their behinds in some type of positive way to help his community, to help you, to help his mom, help his dad. Stop protecting the ones who are taking advantage of other people. Stop protecting them. It's not cute. It doesn't make you empowered. You're not woke. You're damn near dumb. I'm sorry. I have to call it how I see it. That's not what I want to say, especially to my black women, but that's what you are. Because trust and believe, that black man would not protect you if you was accused of sleeping with little boys. That black man would not protect you if you were accused of drugging women and sleeping with them. And we actually know this is true. We just continue to want to step in the name of love, and we want to continue to look at Bill Cosby as our father. Guess what? Those are pieces of men. And they're pieces of men because we predominantly, not saying completely 100% responsible, but we kept coddling them. Oh, no, it's okay. Them girls is fast. Them girls won't fast. Them girls is teenagers. What you talking about? Listen, them girls won't fast with Bill Cosby. They was drugged. And even if they decided to take the drug, taking a drug does not mean you get to rape me. Y'all, it don't mean you get to rape me. It means I took a drug because I want to get high, because I want to feel good. Not because I want you to fucking take my damn body and do what you want. I think that's sick to even rape somebody who can't even respond back sexually. What kind of demented fuck is that? When you know better, you do better, you expect better. Stop feeling a black man.